We have been working on our series, Three Handmade Tools. But there's a lot of things that I do at the wheel that don't fit into the series of Three Handmade Tools. So we've started another series called Tiny Tips from the Clay Teacher. And it's just that. It's little tips I've learned along the way that I'm going to share with you. Now the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to sit at the wheel. And my first tip is when I sit down at the wheel, I always sit down with my tools ready and my needle in this little ball of clay just like that. I like to have my needle handy. It gets lost down in there and I can't find it. And my next tip is sometimes your needle, when it gets laying around or the clay dries around it, it doesn't rust so much, but it gets all rough and kind of dirty. And then it's really coarse, and when you're cutting your pots off, it makes it so they're not tidy. So what you can do is just, I like to clean it on the edge. Just use your wheel head like a grinder, and then it's all nice and shiny and tidy, and for cutting off, it does a good job. And don't worry about wearing the wheel head down. I've been doing this to this wheel head since 1975, and we're fine. Okay, I've gone ahead to my next tiny tip from the clay teacher. I've thrown this bowl, and I purposely threw it so the bottom is really thin, and sometimes that happens not so much on purpose. And so what I'm going to do is, if I were to cut it with a wire, you'd see the wire right through the bottom. And if you can see that, is just about not there. It's about, depending on the camera, very thin. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to thicken it up. I'm going to get a ball of clay. This is too big. I'm going to get about this big a piece of clay. And of course, if it's a larger bottom, be a larger piece, and a smaller bottom. I'm going to roll it into a little bit of a ball, and I'm going to put it over here on a piece of paper. And I'm just going to tap and turn, and I'm going to make a nice, even little pancake out of clay. You can, if you want, fold it over and just tap it out. You can, if you want, get up and roll this on the slab roller, but I'm too lazy to do that. Okay, now I've just got this nice little, even, flat little pancake. It's not perfect. Pots are like people. Very few of us are perfect. But what I'm going to do now, I have this pancake all ready to go. I'm just going to sit there and wait, and I'm going to put it on the bottom here. I'm going to make sure the clay I'm adding it to is completely dry. And I did do an open bottom bowl so you can see. You can see that I'm just going to get rid of that and make sure it's completely dry. Then I'm going to make sure this is dry, and I'm going to put it in mostly the middle. Now don't worry about if it's exactly centered, because it really doesn't matter. And then with my thumb and turning the wheel with my hand, I'm going to start working my way out and making sure there's no air trapped between my little pancake and my skinny little bottom. And I'm going to just work it out. I'm not going to work the edges in, because I'm going to cut the edges off. I should have known where that was. And I'm just going to hold this needle straight down. And of course, now I'm going to have a centered little patch. And this should, when the cameras aren't watching, peel right out of there. You can put that with your other stuff. Stand up. And grab your sponge. And then we're just going to flatten this bottom out and work it in to your bowl. So now you have, now we're going to work that piece of clay like you would any other bottom. Now, if you can see it or not, you've got a kind of a weird angle, and the bowl's wanting to kind of flop out this way. I like to keep my bowls in control. My last tiny tip from the clay teacher telling you about bowls today is how to keep that bowl in check. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure both sides are moist, and I'm going to put my sponge there, and I'm going to put a little bit below my hand, and that motion is going to bring that bowl top into check. Then I'm going to blend that all in. If you do have a messy bit, you can use just the edge of your thumb where one starts and the other one ends. But there we go. We went from a too thin bottom to a nice thick bottom that's now as thick as you want. We've got room now for trimming and finishing, and you didn't have to throw away your bowl. So there we go. It is our first in our series of Tiny Tips from the Clay Teacher, and I hope you enjoyed them.